Do your will, Lord. Do your way, I say yes. How many say yes today?
Yes.
How many say yes, Lord?
Yes, Lord.
Let your will be done. Not my will. Let your will be done. My soul says yes. Give God some more praise. Hallelujah. Yay, hallelujah. We give honor to God and to all my brothers and sisters in Christ. I would like to draw your attention just briefly. Amen. Let's go to 1 John. We talked a little bit about this in Vacation Bible School. Like I said, it's still some meat on a bone. Amen. And I want to dissect it a little more because it's good. I tell you, it got good in our classes. Amen. 1 John, the second chapter, the first verse through the sixth. Then we're going to go to Matthew 15 and 8. Let's start with the 1 John, amen, 2 and 1. It says, my little children, these things write I unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. Second verse says, then he is a propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. And now hereby we do know that we know him, if we keep his commandment. He that said, I know him, and keep not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whosoever keepeth his word, in him verily I is the love of God perfected. Hereby know we that we are in him. Sixth verse says, he that saith he abideth in him, of himself also to walk, even as he walked. Let's go to Matthew 15 and 8. This people draw nigh unto me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. May the Lord have a blessing upon the readers and doers of his holy word. We would like to use that as a topic today. Beware of lip service. You may be seated. Beware of lip service. My. Well, Pastor, what do you mean by lip service? You know, you got some professional folk who can talk a good talk. Amen. Lip service, I had to define, I looked. Now, y'all remember, you know, we ain't gonna go a lot of walking. Amen. Amen. We express the words. Amen. But not back them up in deeds. Amen. We expect words, but we don't back them up in deeds. Well, in other words, let's try it like this. You say one thing, but you do something different. Amen. Folk talk a good game. Have y'all met anybody that talk a good game?
Yeah.
Amen. Got a lot of men.
Yeah, yes.
Amen. They tell you all that? What you want to hear?
Come on, Pastor.
Amen. But they do a whole nother thing. Y'all, some of y'all old enough to know what I'm talking about.
Come on, Pastor.
No, go something like this. Baby, you know I love you. Am I right? Girl, I'll do anything for you. Boo, when I met you, I met the best thing ever. But soon as his sister needed a little help, baby need pampers, baby need some Similac. And you sit there and bought a car that can't get to one block to the next. It's because they can get me, but when you look all into it, ain't nothing but a bunch of fluff. Men, let me talk to the men, ain't making women get no love. Men have ever met women, told them how much they love you. Am I right about it? You turn around, you find yourself by yourself. Up there talking about committing suicide. Because of how a woman made you feel. Brother jumping over bridges and jumping out of cars. How many know that there's more fish? And your walk is a whole nother walk. One plus one equals two. If it don't equal, if it walk like a duck, quack like a duck, it's a duck. I don't care how much it doesn't look like an eagle. It's a duck, church. On your job, the same way. On your job, folk talk all that talk.
Come on now.
They wind up promoting over you because they got the gift of gab. It's not about merit, not about none of that, your work ethics.
Come on now.
Somebody passed you up because they ain't your boss here. All y'all in here today. Get the gap, get throwing you under the bus. Talk about everybody in your company trying to walk all over you, stabbing you in the back, taking your work and saying it's their work, doing all kinds of stuff. But they don't have what you have. And I declare today, you got a lot of politicians. Boy, they tell you all kinds of stuff. Don't they tell us things? Oh, we're going to do this. We're going to fix streets. Are y'all in here today? We're going to build buildings. We're going to give you increases on your pay. Am I right about it? We're going to give you free health care. Amen. And all these things. And I declare today, my brothers and sisters, when they get in office, you be like, well, where are they? Amen. Oh, you see them handing money to handing money. And you trying to figure out why did I put you in office? And every street you drive down, you got to watch them knock the bump in. You know, got big old bowl of holes in the street. Got anybody on everything. Yeah, we just keep on. Ooh, and they keep jibbing, 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 jibbing.
Jibbing all the time.
Lip service.
Come on.
Well, Pastor. You talking about the job, talking about community, talk about the government, talk about relationships. Is it lip service in Christianity in church?
Yeah.
I stopped by today to tell you, just like they jibber jab in the world, you got a whole lot of fucking churches. A jibber jab, jibber jab.
You say one thing, but your walk is far from from God's way.
Yes.
Pastor, you know, you're not going to get that many amens. But let's go to our text. I'm almost done. And our text today, here we find the author said, my little children, when I read that, I knew that I'm child of God. Said, my little children, these things I write unto you that you may not sin. It says, sin not, meaning may not, because we know all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. He that said they don't have no sin is a liar. And the truth is not, are y'all in here today? I'm just reading the text where it says, sin not, amen, may not. And it says, if any man sin, that's how I know it means may not. Read it in the Greek. The interpretation now, may not, and if any man do sin, any man sin, you can thank the sin. Come off your high horse. If you think you're holier than now. Nobody here should condemn nobody. Because you don't have power to do it. Don't judge me. Are y'all in here today? Don't make yourself more righteous than God. The only one that can judge me is the Lord our Savior. The one that's qualified, the one that died, bled and died. He got the rights. Am I right about it? I feel like preaching this. And it said here, we have an advocate. And we talked about that advocate during the week. In order to be an advocate, you got to have the credentials. You got to have the know-how. You got to be the subject matter expert. In order to stand in a gap for someone and relay the message to someone else, you got to be well qualified. Well, according to the word of God, Deacon Moses, we got somebody that's well qualified. He has credentials all the way for glory. Well, who is it? I'm talking about the Lamb of God. My war horse born in the valley. I'm talking about the lily of the valley. My water when I get thirsty. Oh, y'all in here. My everything. When I'm hungry, he's my bread. All the way from heaven. He's my daily bread. Because I got an appetite every day. I got needs. Well, who is he? Jesus Christ, the righteous. He's standing in the gap for you and I. I'm trying not to get too happy, too quick. In that second verse, it says, and the propitiation for our sins. And in other words, he is, and he died and for the remission of our sins. In other words, he paid the price. Let's try like this. He's our scapegoat. Are y'all in here today? In other words, you remember the time of Abraham. And God's going to have him crucified. His own son, Isaac. But when he got time to sacrifice his son, there was a ram in a bush. And Jesus here saying that I'm your ram in a bush. When you sin, he intercepts and goes to your father. But you gotta repent and say, Lord, I'm sorry. And stop doing what you're doing. He intercepts your prayers. And he said, Father, listen to me. I got a case here for you. I got Pastor Estelle. He slipped and fell. But he said, Lord, forgive me. Every once in a while you make mistakes, church. But you gotta learn how to repent and get back up again. They said, I'm hard. It's so hard to get back up again. I tried and I tried, but I stopped by today to tell you
to pick you up and place your feet back on solid ground. Now I know you're going to praise. Come on, thank you. Thank you, Lord, for being an advocate and standing in a gap. For me, Lord, wanting to do it and says here. And he said, we do now. We do know now. We know him. If you know him, you keep his command. In other words, don't talk about it, but be about it. They said in the four words, he that saith, I know him, and keep not his commandment, he's a liar, and the truth is not in him. And whosoever keepeth his word, and him dwelleth in the love of God. Amen. Yes, it's perfect. It's complete in Christ.